Hello, my name is Chase Stevens, and today I'm going to be helping you with content on D2L. So let's get started. Now there's two different ways that we can look at content. First, we will look at the content browser located here on the right. This allows you to conveniently navigate through content without having to go through other links. Here you will see a list of modules that the content is organized under. If you click on one of the modules, you will be brought to a list of all content links within that respective module. These content links can be links to submodules, or they can direct you to a desired piece of content. If you are inside a module, you will notice two possible links at the top of the content browser, home and back. Now, you only see back if you are within a submodule. These links are for navigating directly within the content browser. If you have clicked on multiple submodules, the back button will take you one level back, and the home button will take you to the home list of modules. Now, if you're at the home screen, within the content browser, again, you will see two different links, bookmarks and recently viewed items. The recently viewed items link will allow you to view items that you have recently viewed, and we will talk about bookmarks just a little bit later. Now let's look at the second way to interact with content. This will be through the navigation bar. Along the navigation bar, find the content link and click on it. You'll notice that this page is divided into two parts. On the left, we have the content map, and on the right, we have the normal list of content. Both these lists will tell you the same thing, but they just present it in a different way. So let's go ahead and work with the main list here. Here you will see a list of all the content an instructor has uploaded, and it will be sorted by module. If an instructor has assigned a due date to a specific piece of content, a new feature allows you to view that due date directly in the content list. Also, you will notice a completion indicator here on the right. If you have completed the item, you're going to see a check mark. If not, like these here, you're going to see a gray bullet point. At the top of the main content list, you'll also notice a course completion bar. This shows you the progress towards completion of all modules. Now, within a module, there could be various file types, various subcategories, and clicking on one of them will bring you to that specific piece of content. So let's go ahead and look at this PDF here. Now, PDF, along with other file types, could be opened directly in a D2L page, meaning we don't have to go to an external site, nor do we have to download anything. But it's important to remember that there are other files that will require a download. If you click on one of these links, you'll be prompted with a download window that will allow you to open the file immediately or save it for later viewing. So now let's take a look at the PDF that opens directly in the browser. By clicking on it, here, you have a few options and things you can do to interact with your content. First, you will see at the top a drop-down button located next to the content title. Clicking on this will present you with three options. First, you're just going to see download. This is simply a way to download the file for later viewing. Next, you're presented with a newly added feature called Binder. Now, Binder is currently an iPad-specific feature, but it's very useful and simple. It's an external application that will allow you to push and pull files from D2L. To send a piece of desired content to the binder, simply click the drop-down arrow next to the title and click Send to Binder. Now, the binder app will require you to create an Edu Identity account. Once the account is created, you can send the desired content from D2L or pull content from D2L directly to your iPad app. Let's look at this from the iPad view and how to retrieve files. So here we are at the iPad home screen. All you have to do is open the app by clicking on Binder there. Now that PDF that we had just sent, you see a notification here that you have one item. So you can click on that, and you will notice that the PDF is here and available. So now going back to the main content screen, your third and final option under the drop-down arrow is Submit Feedback. Click this and you can leave feedback about the specific piece of content you're on. Now remember, both your instructor and fellow students will be able to see the feedback and that you left it. But if you would like to leave anonymous feedback, this is an option as well. Just make that check mark here. Now moving to the right of the drop-down arrow, you'll notice a couple more icons. First, you'll see the bookmark icon. By clicking on this, it'll mark the piece of content bookmarked and allow you to quickly jump to it later if you know it's something that you're going to be returning to. Your next option is the Open in New Window icon, located just to the right of the bookmark. This will simply take that specific piece of content you're on, open it up in a new browser window. Continuing to move to the right, we have more options. You'll notice a Previous and a Next button. This will allow you to quickly navigate content. By clicking Next, you'll go to the next piece of content listed in the content list. By clicking Previous, you'll go to the previous piece of content listed. Obviously, if you're on the first item, the Previous button won't be available. And if you're on the last item of content, the next item or the next button is not going to be available. So let's go back to the main content page, and you'll notice just a few more options. Right above the content map is a search bar. Here you can type in terms or keywords to allow you to sort through content very quickly. For example, if you type the word syllabus, the results pop up just to the right of the search bar. Now, if we go back to the main content page, we could see our other options. Looking directly below that search bar, you'll see a bookmarks tab. Any item that you have bookmarked will be listed here so that you can quickly return to it. Now, directly below the bookmarks tab is an upcoming events tab. Here, any events that your instructor has uploaded, due dates, field trips, tests, they'll all be listed here. Lastly, each module, including the table of contents, will have its own download button located just under the module title. Depending on the module you're on, all items within that module will be downloaded. This will give you a zip folder containing all the items within the selected module. Then, just unzip the folder and you'll have all the content. If you want all the content within a specific course, go to the Tables of Contents and click the Download button, and all content items will be downloaded. So that covers it for content. Again, my name is Chase Stevens, and I would like to thank you for tuning in.